Good morning, dear children. Now we are going to study letter writing in today's class. Dear children, letters enable us to communicate thoughts, needs, feelings, and information to others when we cannot express them verbally or directly. When we are not able to talk to the person directly or verbally, we just write the message. In that, we express our thoughts, we express our needs, our feelings, and we give the information through the letter writing. Dear children, there are two kinds of letter writings. Two types of letter writings. The first one is personal letter, or which are also known as informal letters. Personal or informal letters. And the second kind of letter writing is official or the formal. Official or the formal letters. Clear? Letters are of two types. First one is personal or informal, and second one is official or formal letters. Personal or informal letters help us to be in touch with our friends, our relatives, and our dear ones. Personal letters help us to keep in touch with our friends. We write personal letters to our friends, our relatives, our known persons. Okay? And then comes the official or formal letters. Official letters are written to convey official requests or suggestions, as well as to serve as records. We write official letters to authorities, higher authorities. Why we write? To convey official requests or suggestions, to convey official matters. Clear? And they are also served as a record. They are kept as a record. The official or formal letters are kept as a record. Now I think you understood what is a letter and writing, and what are the types of letter writing. The most important thing we have to learn is the format of letter writing. How to write a letter. For both the letters, personal letters and official letters, there is a difference in format. Clear? Now, one by one, step by step, I will teach you the format of letter writing. First of all, we'll discuss about personal letters. Personal letters. Okay? What is the format of personal letters? Format. Got it? Dear children, like notice and message, letter is never written in the box. Notice and message we always write inside the box, but letters are never written in the box. Always remember. Dear children, suppose this is our margin. Clear? We should write all the points from the margin side. Step by step we'll be learning. First of all, in personal letters, dear children, we start our letter with sender's address. Sender's address. Clear? When you will be writing, you will not be writing here sender's address. You will directly write the address. Clear? Sender's address means one who is sending a letter. Suppose I am writing a letter to my friend, means I have to write my address. Clear? That is called the sender's address. I'll write the address and show you. You were sector 5 whatever is your address we write. This is called the sender's address. Sorry, sender's address. Clear? First of all, we write sender's address, the address of the person who is sending a letter, and it should be mentioned at the left hand corner. Should always write from the left hand side. Clear? After writing the sender's address, we leave one line gap. Here, I'm showing you this mark for leaving the line. Clear? After leaving this line, you have to write the date on which you are writing a letter. Suppose you are writing this letter on 29th September 2020. Clear? You should mention the date. Okay? Then, after writing the date, again you have to leave the line. After that comes the salutation. Suppose you are writing this letter to Drishti, your friend. Dear Drishti. Clear? What it is called? It is called the salutation. What we call it? Salutation. Clear? It is called salutation. We can write, my dear loving friend, my dear Drishti. In this way, we can write the salutation. This is the format of personal letter. Of the official letter, I will tell you later on. After this, I will tell you. Okay? And then, after the salutation, again, you have to leave one line. And then comes the important matter about what we are writing. And all this is called body of the letter. What we call it? Body of the letter. All important. It can be of one paragraph or two small paragraphs. Clear? That is body of the letter. And when we'll write body of the letter, all the lines should start from the margin side. Need not to leave the space. Clear? And when the body of the letter is over, you have to write the subscription. I'm erasing the board, there is less space, so this is the concluding part of the letter. Subscription. It is the concluding part of the letter. This is written at the end of the letter at the bottom left hand corner after the body of the letter. Like salutation, subscriptions can also be written in many ways. How we can write? What are the subscriptions for personal letters? You can write yours lovingly or yours affectionately, yours ever or ever yours. Likewise, many subscriptions you can write after the body of the letter. And this is the end of your letter. Clear? After the subscription, yours lovingly or with love. This is the subscription, and then you have to mention your name. Suppose Reena is writing this letter. Did you understand the format of the this personal letter? On the top, you should write the sender's address, the person who is sending a letter. After sender's address, you will leave one line and then write the date. After the date, leave one line and then write the salutation. After the salutation, again leave one line and then write body of the letter. It can be 2 paragraphs, 3 paragraphs, according to your choice. Clear? And then after body of the letter comes the subscription, or it is also called complimentary clause. Clear? And there can be many kinds of complimentary clause for personal letters. I have already told you, like yours affectionately, yours ever or ever yours, yours. Likewise, many subscriptions we can write. You can see here on page number 219, the list is given. Okay, and then at last you have to write your name. This is the format of the personal or informal letter. Now, dear children, let's see the format of official letter. Format of official letter. There is little bit difference in the format of personal and official letter. What is that? In official letter also, we first of all we write the sender's address. Clear? Sender's address we write on the top. Sender's address means one who is sending the letter. Clear? After the sender's address, we leave one line and then we mention the date. Suppose this letter is written on, suppose this letter is written on 29th September 2020. Clear? Then after the date, again you have to leave one line and then you have to write a receiver's address. Receiver's address. Receiver's address, one who is going to receive a letter. Clear? Okay. Dear children, after receiver's address, again we leave one line gap. Clear? After receiver's address, we write the subject. Subject heading we write. For what? What is the reason? Clear reason of writing a letter we mention in that. Subject. For if it is leave application, we can write leave application or letter for the post of an office clerk or whatever is the reason we mention in that. And the reason, the subject should always be underlined. Clear? The subject heading should be always underlined. After writing the subject, then we write the salutation. Now, the salutation of official letters are little different. I mean, we can write just sir or madam, or we can write dear sir, dear madam. Okay, these are the these salutations we use for personal, official letters. This is called the salutation. First of all, we write the sender's address. Then we leave one line gap. And then we write the date on which we are writing a letter. After the date, again, we leave one line. After the date, we write receiver's address, one who is going to receive the letter. After receiver's address, we write the subject heading. And whatever is the subject heading should be always underlined. Again, leave one line after the subject heading. Then write the salutation. So, madam or dear sir or madam. And then again, after the salutation, you should leave one line. And then you should write the body of the letter. Clear? In body of the letter, again, you have to mention the important points. You should tell in detail about what you are going to write a letter. Clear? After the salutation comes body of the letter. Body of the letter. Clear? Then after body of the letter comes the complimentary clause. Leave one line here and then the subscription or the complimentary clause comes. Clear? And here the different complimentary clauses we can use, like yours faithfully, or faithfully yours, yours sincerely, yours obediently, yours truly, sincerely. All these are the complimentary clause for the official letters. Clear? And then at last you have to write your name, the person who is writing a letter. Your name and your designation also can be mentioned in this. Only the two differences we can see in the format of the personal letter and the official letter. What is that? In personal letters, we do not mention the receiver's address. In personal letters, the receiver's address is only written on the envelope. Clear? But in official letters, we write the receiver's address also. In personal letters, we do not write the subject heading. But in official letters, we mention the subject heading. Only these are the two differences. Okay? Dear children, whether we write the for personal letter or official letter, everything should start from the margin side. First of all, we write the sender's address in personal letters. Then we write the date. And after writing the date, we write the salutation. Clear? Then we write body of the letter. Then we write the complimentary clause. Then the name of the person and designation. Clear? And in the official letter, first of all, we write the sender's address. Then we write the date. Then we write the receiver's address. After receiver's address, we write the subject heading. And after subject heading, we write the body of the letter. After body of the letter, we write the complimentary clause. And then at last, the name and designation of the person who is writing a letter. I hope you understood very clearly the format of the letter writing. Dear children, I have given you the format of notice writing, message writing and the letter writing. When I will send you the notice, message and letter, you will be writing them in your notebook. Clear? And that also exactly according to the format what I have taught you. Clear? I have clearly told you when and where you have to leave the lines. Clear? So you have to follow all these instructions and then write, maintain your copies. Clear? Samples are already given in your book for notice, for message and letter writing. You can go through them. It will be a great help for you to understand it. Okay? So pay attention and study well. Thank you.